So this is the third day now, and our story is entering its third phase. The next morning, Red Dog realized that he was looking forward to sitting next to Nancy. Now, the story is from Red Dog's perspective. For the past 2 days, it was Nancy who was trying her best to win the dog's heart. But this morning, Red Dog realized that he was looking forward to sitting next to Nancy. When do you look forward to meet someone? When you are now accustomed to that person. He is looking forward to sitting next to Nancy. Why? Because, let's see, and when she sat next to him, he forgot to try to push her off. He thought that he might just try being a bit aloof, but when she said, "Hi, Red," and patted him on the head, he couldn't help smiling a little in the way that dogs do. He thumped his tail on the seat, once only, and then went back to looking out of the window, not wanting to give way too much to begin with. How is Red Dog behaving? He is looking forward to meeting Nancy. Why? Because Nancy had the heart. She was courageous enough to mock all the men sitting in the bus. And she said, "None of you are gentlemen." And he wanted to show Nancy that he was a gentleman and that he would let her sit next to him. So, when Nancy got on the bus, he absolutely forgot to push her off. And what did he do? Instead, he tried to be a bit aloof. He tried to show that he did not notice her presence. But what happened? When she said, "Hi, Red," and patted the dog on its head, he smiled the way dogs do. How did he show his smile? He thumped. He was happy. He greeted Nancy. How did he smile? How did he greet? He thumped his tail. He wagged and touched his tail on the seat, but only once. Why? Because he did and started looking out of the window because he didn't want to give too much to begin with. He didn't want to be too... In the simplest words, he didn't want to be too free. He didn't want to get too chum with Nancy. Nancy didn't turn around, but she could tell that the miners were impressed and weren't mocking at her anymore. She knew she had scored a victory over them at the same time as she had won over the Red Dog. Now, without even turning, she knew that everybody in the bus was impressed with her slow progress. Although the progress was slow, yet she has won the heart of the dog. And she has won over all the men sitting in the bus, along with winning the heart of the Red Dog. From that moment onwards, Red Dog and Nancy became friends. There were not many others who dared to try it, but Nancy sat next to him whenever she liked. So, that sense of belonging of the dog with the seat that he chose was slowly shared with Nancy. Why? Because Nancy was courageous enough to take a stand for herself and sit next to the dog. Let's have a look at the vocabulary. There are a lot of Australian words. Previously, when we were reading Becoming Too American, we came across American English words such as curb and station wagon and gas pedal. This time, we are going to come across Australian words. Australian English has many words and expressions which are not part of standard English. Standard English is the British English. In the text, Going, Gone, in Unit 5, you came across Australian words such as coals, marsupials, which are basically marsupials such as mice, and spinifex, which are prickly undergrowth, prickly thorn bushes. In this text, you meet three new words. The first one is utes, which are utility vehicles such as pickup trucks. Then we come across words such as wallaroos and wallabies. Wallaroos are small animals midway in size between kangaroo and wallabies. All of these animals are large marsupials. Marsupials are animals which have a pocket in their front belly to keep their babies. The marsupials, by the way, are mammals. All of these animals are large marsupials common in Australia, which hop on massive back legs and keep their babies in pouches. A roo tail is the track left. A roo trail is the track left in vegetation by the kangaroos, wallabies, and wallaroos. Okay? So, okie dokie. Here is your writing task. I'm so sorry, my Zoom wasn't working, so I have to make today's lesson through my camcorder, hence the unstable hand and disturbance and, you know, whatever is going on. Now, your task is page 190. 189, writing task. The events in this story take place over 3 days. You're going to write detailed diary entries for those 3 days for two people, Nancy Gray and a red dog. To prepare for writing your diary entries, make two headings, Nancy and red dog. Read through the text again carefully and jot down their actions and feelings. Okay? Meaning that you have to attempt, you have to write down 3 diary entries for day 1, day 2, day 3. And from 2 perspectives, number 1 from the perspective of Nancy and number 2 from the perspective of Red Dog. Use these notes to write your diary entries. Make up the days and dates of your diary entries. Okay, first what you have to do is just like you did for James and James' parents. You have to make 2 columns, 1 for Nancy, 1 for Red Dog. And for all the 3 days, take down the notes of how Nancy reacts and how the red dog is experiencing the whole situation and how Nancy is experiencing the whole situation. First, read through from the perspective of Nancy. Take down the notes that you need to as, thinking of yourself as Nancy, and then again read through the text from the perspective of the red dog. ठीक है? और उसके बाद कैसी उनको, क्या actions वो कर रहे हैं, क्या feelings उनको आ रही हैं, ये आपने note down करना है, ठीक है? फिर इन नोट्स को यूज करके आपने डायरी एंट्रीज लिखनी है नैन्सी की तरफ से और रेड डॉग की तरफ से. ठीक है, बिल्कुल जिस तरह आप उसमें डायरी में एंट्री करते हो. मेक अप द डेज एंड डेट्स ऑफ योर डायरी एंट्रीज. ठीक है, आप खुद से अब इमेजिनरी डेज और डेट्स डालेंगे. ठीक है, और फिर इसके बाद आपका लास्ट टॉपिक पॉइंट है, एक मिनट, पेज नंबर 190 के ऊपर. That's about it. ठीक हो गया. With that we come to the end of the lesson. This is your task for the day. I hope you have understood the text and this is a very easy task. Diary entries लिखना कोई मुश्किल नहीं होता. ऊपर date sheet डाल के बिल्कुल जैसे आप अपनी personal diary maintain करते हैं उस तरह से आपने Nancy Gray की तरफ से पहले लिखना है, तीनों दिन Nancy Gray ने क्या experience किया, और फिर आपने Red Dog की तरफ से लिखना है कि Red Dog ने as a लिविंग बींग क्या एक्सपीरियंस किया. ठीक है, आप रेड डॉग को परस्पेक्टिव से भी लिखना सीखें कि एक इनएनिमेट ऑब्जेक्ट, एक नॉन ह्यूमन किस तरह से अपना परस्पेक्टिव देगा. थैंक यू वेरी मच.